Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how to take a scrolling screenshot on Windows 10 and Windows 11. And if you get any value out of this video, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. But to get started with the guide, if you want to take a screenshot of a web page and you want to make that screenshot scroll down or up for that matter, the first thing you'll have to do is take the screenshot of the web page, and I have another guide that'll show you how you can download the Go Full Page browser extension that I already have installed here, and I'll leave a link to that in the description of this video. But you want to install the Go Full Page browser extension and then go to the web page that you want to take a screenshot of, and then click on the Go Full Page browser extension. And if you do that, it's going to start taking a screenshot of that entire web page. Now, once you have the web page here, you can either download it as a PDF or as a PNG. But for this video, we're going to download it as a PNG so we can put it into our video editing software. So click on download PNG and then click on allow if you do get any prompts. I'm just going to open this file in my downloads folder. And then what you want to do is you want to download and install CapCut on your computer. And I also have guides on my channel that'll show you how you can download and install CapCut for PC. But once you have CapCut, you can open up a new project, and then you can import this picture into CapCut, and then you can add it to the timeline. Now, to make the screenshot scroll, basically to make it a video, you need to determine the length that you want it to be. Right now, it's 5 seconds in length. I'm just going to keep it on 5 seconds for this video. And then you need to go to the start of this clip. And because this is a full web page screenshot, you'll see that it's quite small and we have to zoom in. Now, first in CapCut, just click on this ratio button and then make sure it's on 16:9 if you want widescreen, which is what I want here. And now I need to zoom in so I can see this screenshot better. So I'll click on the scale slider and increase it all the way to 500. And now you'll see the issue here is we still have these black bars here on the side, but the scale is already set to max. So to fix that, just click inside of the scale box and then change the number here. I'm going to change it to 800 and then press enter on the keyboard. And now I can see that's a bit better, but it's not quite full screen yet. So I'll change it to 1200, and it needs to go a little bit more. So I'll go to 1400, and that looks fine. Now, obviously you have this full web page screenshot here, and it depends on what you want to do with it. But I'm just going to use keyframes to start at the top of this web page and then scroll down until, let's say, about here. So what I'm going to do is I'll position the playhead at the start of this clip where it is now. Then I'll take this screenshot and I'll align it to the top. And then I'm going to add a keyframe to position and size. So it's going to keyframe all of that. And now I'm going to move the playhead all the way to the end of this clip. And then I'm just simply going to move the screenshot all the way to where I want it to be at the end of this clip. And I said that I wanted it to end right there. So now what will happen is, if I play out this clip, the screenshot will scroll down. And at the end of the clip, it'll stop where I wanted it to stop. Now, if you wanted this to scroll even faster, then obviously you would just make it go down even further. So if I change this and I make it go down all the way to here and I position it here and I play out this clip, it's going to scroll much faster. Now that's a little too fast, so I'll just make it go back to where I wanted it at the beginning, which is here. Now I have another guide on my channel explaining keyframes in CapCut in a little bit more depth, so you can go ahead and watch that if this is a little bit confusing to you. But now if you wanted to take this clip and make it part of one of your videos or wherever you want to use it, you can just go ahead and click on the export button up here, and then you can give it a name. You can choose a save location. I'm just going to choose the desktop for this example, and you can choose your resolution up until 4K. I'm just going to leave all of these settings like that and then click on export. And now if we go ahead and play this video, it'll be the screenshot that we took that's scrolling down. So I hope this guide's been useful and wasn't too confusing. Please like the video and I'll see you in the next one.